Yep.
Now I can't ride a Coda bus without getting a fucking plug.
Can't go nowhere. You know, I like to go to the fucking fish market and get some fish and some donuts. They be looking at me crazy as hell, man. I'm taking a chance, you know. I'm fucking digging a hole through the shit. You know what I'm saying? Most I see that too. Most I see that with your shit. But anyway, these motherfuckers, like I said, man, we marking these motherfuckers. You got more of that
offer? Yeah. What about Gemini 5 and 3? Those are high water. Not find hydroponic juice. It has trickled them, but they have not breathed. They have, God has consumed them, but they have refused to receive correction.
We shall overcome. What's the saying these motherfuckers be coming up with? We shall overcome.
No justice, no peace.
Black lives matter. All that crazy. Yeah, I see. All that madness, man.
Yeah, like a homosexual probably gets like STD, whatever the fuck it is. We still continue doing what we're doing.
Don't learn.
And everybody see him all jacked up and sick, and they still gonna say it's cool to be a homosexual. But here it is.
That's what the news 2 or 3 days ago, man.
Yeah, they call him bug chasing.
Is that what they call him?
That's what he is.
It was on the news 2 or 3 days ago. He caught it on purpose just so he can go straight.
That's what they do.
You know, and think of if he's that's just one. Think of how many other motherfuckers got that mentality.
That's part of their culture.
You know, they caught that black bitch that was on Backpage who had AIDS, and she was fine as a motherfucker. Fine as fuck, and she knew she was able to spread. Fine, man. She was going around, I mean, you never know who she done got. She done got a lot of motherfuckers. It's just growing and growing. Motherfuckers, it's crazy, man.
But they have refused to receive correction. They have made their faces harder than a rock. They have refused to return. Therefore I said, surely these are poor, they are foolish, but they know not the way of Yahweh, nor the judgment of their God.
I would say that fucking stink, bro.
Oh, man, that shit is fucking
weird. That shit is disrespectful though, bro. Yeah. You smoke that shit around people and out public and shit, man. Yeah. That shit is not, that shit fucking stink, bro. I mean, it's disrespectful to smoke cigarettes around people, let alone that shit. Disrespectful as hell, bro. People ain't got no decency.
I would never accept that smoke cigarettes, man.
You
got Hebrew? What's up, man?
You got Hebrew?
All day long?
Israelite.
I'm a Hebrew Israelite.
I'm surprised to see y'all out here.
You know, twice, yeah. Huh? What you say you supposed?
Well, I'm just surprised to see, but every time I see y'all.
Okay.
Too far. And he's scattered us. He's scattered.
Right. Well, we came together years ago, though.
We're not here for
we the only group in Columbus that's coming out here continuously every week. We're the only group in
about
Columbus.
About 10 years.
Right.
So y'all part of the camp or what?
Huh?
This is the camp.
When we leave here?
Yeah.
We don't live together. We go our separate ways. We still talk, communicate, whatever.
You know, I mean, like they have camps that live together.
Oh, no.
They probably got GLCC.
We ain't trying to drive each other crazy.
They
got
their own
camp. They got camps everywhere. IUYC, they got camps too.
They do got camps everywhere, but they don't go out like they're supposed to.
No.
Well,
yeah, I do. I've seen it in my hometown. I'm from Chicago.
You know what that is? Timothy?
Yeah.
I know this one. You know what the thing is, our people are in and the stress. These are desperate moments we're living in now. We ain't got no time to be taking time off anyway. We don't have no business taking time off. The devil ain't taking time off. Right, the devil's constantly doing his thing, man. His counterproductive videos. His counter-videos when it comes to pushing his truth.
You know about IUIC, though?
Yeah.
You know that Nate guy, right? Did you know he's a detective?
No.
A lot of people don't know that.
He knocked out like two
brothers in the truth. He knocked them up. That's right. Everybody knows about it.
He
didn't deny it.
Lately, I've been on Facebook. Right. I ain't been keeping up with what's going on right recently. But, you know, I just keep it with myself and my family.
Yeah.
You know, so far, I got a couple spiritual brothers that I've talked to. I'm all over the Washington State, Delta, Georgia.
But you gotta connect with your family, your real family.
Right.
Your real family is the people that's pushing this truth, that's pushing this work. But hell with your other family. Because you know the thing is, we ain't got no family anywhere.
We say I come to separate the fathers from the sons.
That's right, you bring your vision.
That tells you right there. Your biological family is not necessarily your family.
Right. That is the biggest enemy.
It
can be, you know.
It can be. You have to do it that way. It's not always. And the thing is, man, it's so funny. I'm realizing too that I think the devil got me again. I got married. And my wife, I've been known for 25, 26 years. There's a gap in between, you know, like she went off to be a flight attendant and I went out to California to work in the business I was doing, right? We kept in contact, you know. And so the woman that I called, the woman of God,
right,
you know. I was connected back with her again, and I'm thinking, you know, I'm explaining the truth because when I first came to 26 years ago, I knew I could do it, right? But now, when I did, I came and I connected with her, and I turned the person by the rule, the order, right? She said, yeah, I accept it, I receive it, I understand it, and then, but her ways are actually not strong.
Because she hasn't accepted it.
Right,
yeah. We all know about that.
And she definitely ain't gonna learn this because the scripture says they're never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. It's not possible. They might learn basic shit, covering their hair, wearing a dress.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Uh-huh. They might learn basic stuff. For a woman, I believe it's harder for a woman because they really did say, you know, and I'm doing a thing of study. I do my own studies on my own, you know, I put my information down and I write it down, you know. But one of the things I'm coming, this says in Genesis, third chapter, it's talking about the what God's judgment, or actually his punishment that he gave to Eve.
Yeah.
It says that the serpent shall bruise her heel, and she shall crush his head. And people don't understand that. He said put enmity between the two.
Actually, you know what that's really talking about? The woman right there is talking about Israel, actually. And the serpent is talking about Esau.
That.
Yeah. I mean, you can go both ways with it.
Yeah, I understand that.
Yeah.
I understand that one too.
Revelation is talking about the woman.
So I'm gonna hit you with this though. Like right now in this time that we're living in, we're not really concerned with the woman. I mean, we're gonna teach her or whatever, but really, we're about getting the men together. Because the men's gonna be the leaders. You know, the woman, when we get power, the women gonna follow. Just like, what's that Psalms 110? Now, and people shall be willing in the day that power. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So the women just gonna follow power and money. Whoever got that, that's who they riding with. You know?
I mean, because this world is talking that. Independent, liberalness, out of God's order, natural order. So if you ain't in order, then you out of order.
Yep.
I actually believe I'm on my way to get a divorce. To be honest with you,
one of the things I do
is I say right now, this word, what he comes to do, he says, husband, deal with your wives according to knowledge.
Yep.
So every time she comes to me with some craziness, some kind of crazy place, something, I point it out to her in that book. I point out to what he said in that book. That way it's no longer what I'm thinking or what I want, it's what God said. Now, if you think I'm wrong, then you get in that book and you show me why I'm wrong.
She tried to, too. You know, what am I trying to teach you, though, you know?
She knows I know that word too well, man.
Yeah,
I know that word too well.
Michael said this, especially not in a friend, when you're not confident in the God,
keep the doors of thy mouth from hurting thy life and thy bosom.
Like I said, just give them the basic stuff. Nothing to trust. You know, eat clean shit.
It don't really matter if your woman believes. The scripture says, the woman doesn't believe that. Paul said that in Corinthians, the woman don't believe should be saved by your faith.
So don't worry about what
you're doing. A lot of times you're going to get yourself in trouble telling your woman all this stuff.
Like, I even have to deal with it. Like, they have this old saying, the apple don't fall far from the tree. Well, her mother did the same thing. I heard her mother tell me, the other day, not too long ago, that, oh no, the Bible don't follow that. I said, excuse me? I said, oh, our conversation is over.
Yeah, you crazy.
I said, tell her, mother, now, I have respect for my elders, don't get me wrong. But when my elders don't have respect for my God, then I don't have respect for you anymore.
Most I don't respect the elders.
I don't respect the elders.
There ain't no elders. That's why he's pulling his truth. That's right. And that's majority in the truth is young men.
That's right.
So he care less about old motherfuckers.
What's that?
They old wise. You go to the book of Job, and Job tell you that the wise men don't obtain knowledge.
That's what wisdom, right.
These old motherfuckers is old fools, man. They nothing like an old fool.
The scripture said there's no respect.
People so fucked up.
What's that scripture? There's no respect
for old
fools.
Yeah.
What's there's no respect to person.
There you go.
Was that James 2:9?
Every time she tried to bring it to me, I tear it down.
Yeah, you gotta let her have it.
Man.
You know what I mean? This is
I can't do it, man. I can't.
He's stubborn. Like that.
Yeah, I'm stubborn like
that. Yeah, that's how I am too.
I'm stubborn for the most time, man. I would not let it go. I crush it. She can't stand it.
You always like that before. Revenge.
Yeah, I just give up on her after a while. Like, man, you just do what you do. I'm gonna do me.
Ezekiel 16:44. Behold, everyone that uses proverbs, shall use this proverb against thee, saying, as is the mother, so is the daughter.
So is the daughter.
What is that? Proverbs 16:44. So mama, old ho, what you think the daughter's gonna be?
Exactly.
You know, I've witnessed it myself with my mom, man. My sister, man. You know, they on a whole level, different level of prostitution.
You know, she don't even get it. I mean, it's like, I go off with her about Timothy, but, you know, showing her everything.
But check it out, you know what? That's what I said to you, like, the men of the Lord is your family and not the family. Not your family, no. Most I don't want no man that can't look at his family and tell them they're doing wrong, or tell their mama, and confess mom and dad is going off too. That don't mean you go to mom and dad and cuss them out, because you still got to respect mom and dad. But you're still a witness to what they're doing.
It's just a tough situation all around.
Tough for me. You motherfuckers don't mean anything. They don't mean shit to me.
They
didn't wake me up to the truth.
I had to look. My dad, okay, he called himself the father Christian too, right? So he tried to take my wife's side about an issue that she was dead wrong about, right? And so I had to go off of him. I started to tell him.
Stepdad, you mean?
Yeah. I had to tell him, not my real dad. I had to tell him, I think.
You can show them scriptures and stuff. Yeah.
But they don't receive this. They want to make an excuse for why it's okay to make a They get mad at me. My family get mad at me because I won't serve this holiday. Christmas and birthdays and New Year's. And they get mad at me because I don't give nobody no gift.
They be like, Merry Christmas. My mom got mad at telling me this year because I didn't say Happy Mother's Day. She kept saying, and then she got something to say to me. That's what she kept saying. I'm like, no.
Right.
They got mad at me, trying to send me on a guilt trip. You know?
Let me read this real quick. It's like, Sprock 3 and,
Does she say Happy Father's Day?
Hell no.
Nobody give a damn about dad, man. Father don't give me shit.
It's Sprock 3. Since my son helped thy father in his age, he grieved him not as long as he lived. If his understanding fail, have patience with him, and despise him not when thou art in thy full strength.
My dad totally does it, man. You know what I told him? I told him, I said, you know, I love you. They don't. This dude still screaming and hollering on the phone. See, I was so face to face with my dad, and I ain't coming. I couldn't go off on him because he's my dad.
Yeah, it's hard, man.
Right. And I keep trying to tell him, here, you gotta look. You gotta look at the scripture. Look at it. But you know what? It's going real slowly. You know.
Put this up.
Sometimes you just gotta hit them with parables, and they might even catch it right away.
This is what I'm pushing
on. You know what? When all your life you've been doing wrong. Nobody, like, nigga, don't want to be corrected.
Romans 11. Romans 11 is talking about. It's talking about being grafted in. But when you get to like the fourth verse, it starts talking about it's bringing back the old when Isaiah was speaking. So they dug down the altars and they put all your prophets.
Right. Check it out, man. We work how the Most High work. Can't work. We work in a spirit of prophecy. Yeah. We go precept upon precept. We don't read the whole chapter like the Holocaust Dollars. You know what I'm saying? Like, we just read precept. When you read a chapter, it don't it switch up the topics?
And
you know what I mean? It switches up too much. That's totally out of order. Right. Hero little.
Right. Exactly. Just like brother was saying about, you know, your mother and your father, you know what I'm saying? Like how was that said so himself? Like, who's my brother? Look, get that. Who was my brother? Who was my mother? Right. So he took, who was my brother? Who was my mother? That
real, is an effect. That's why you can't get too mad at these people. people sometimes, you know? You just gotta let it go. Yeah, you gotta let it go.
I get so frustrated with
people today. That's something I had problem dealing with. I get better at it the older I get, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
You gotta learn how to just let it go.
Let it go.
I used to get mad as hell when somebody didn't get it, bro. I mean, yelling, bang, popping up my head, you know?
That's why I'm quick, man.
You're right.
That's why
I'm quick.
Some quick,
man. You're right.
Some quick, man.
Yeah, you're right.
Some quick, man.
Because people think I be trying to avoid her, but bro, I just don't like talking to her.
Hey, G, can you help me get going?
We got all kind of brothers out here.
You strutting there? That camp is over all the camps in the Midwest. Exactly. Chicago is over all these camps.
That's Chirac right
there.
They're
actually about to start coming at your camps and cracking down on shit. Who's your brother? Elijah. E-L-I-J-A-H. E-L-I-J-A-H.
Boy, read that out.
I tell you, man, you know, the Most High, if he ain't working with you, man, he gonna make you believe in a lie, man. He can also take you out of the truth, too, man, if you ain't doing according to his will.
Yes, he is.
Just like for my wife, for instance, man, when she ain't walking through and school for the Most High, then she comes back to that individual. Saying that she God.
Right, I'm gonna hit you with this, bro. A lot of times, the Israelite woman didn't know she's an Israelite, is the most bugged out person on the earth.
Yeah, really?
That crazy.
Really?
Crazy.
Well, it's the worst women I've ever
encountered. Crazy. Insanity.
Worst women I've ever encountered was Israelite
women. Whacked. Totally.
Over here? In Columbus? Yeah.
I done seen it time and time again.
Like the last couple of weeks, I've been talking to a couple of them in Dayton. They're the worst people, man, I've ever met, man. I have better conversation with hoes on the street. A prostitute than them Israelite bitches, man.
Hey, what did the Lord say about the prostitutes, though? That they going to enter the kingdom before a lot of these men that call themselves men of the Lord.
That's right.
So that's how we gotta think, you know what I mean?
That's deep, bro. I never really thought about it like that.
I ain't trying to teach you, but they trying.
I just encountered with one woman that was Israelite, you know, that knew she was Israelite already at home. And I guess you're right. She did turn out to be a little
crazy.
She did. I didn't get too deep with her, you know what I mean? So
a lot of dudes is bugged out too, though.
A lot of them. I'm not gonna say
what I'm talking about as far as like tribe-wise, like Southern tribe got it worse, man. Yeah. Like we just got so much pride and ego, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? For real. Like you don't see no Hispanic men into that Kemetic stuff, man. You don't see no Northern men into that.
It's just how people act.
It's a Southern thing, man. It's too Jesuit.
No, they didn't get that.
You know why they didn't get that
in San Francisco?
And that's
sad. That's crazy.
Yeah, right.
But Israel pulling off everything.
Yeah.
All across the board.
He want to follow everything. But
right. What is this? Is it an ox going to
follow? Yeah. But it's said we're gonna be like that. They said we're gonna follow God's made of wood and stone. Christianity and Muslim faith.
So this is
the largest. You black people are the largest you should follow, right? You know what I'm saying?
That's the only thing we mainly follow.
Yeah. And so hard, like, I got a brother, one home.